Information Minister Kojo Ponkrumah says the National Democratic Congress flag bearer and former President John Mahama is deceiving undecided Ghanaians to win votes. Reacting to his Facebook Live broadcast on Thursday, Kojo Ponkrumah said government is disappointed but not surprised at his posture. John Dramani Mahama ran down the NPP government on a number of policies.
That after all of these years of being involved in public life, having an opportunity to be involved in the management of the economy, running it down, having to go to the IMF for a bailout program, even as at this point in time, the former president is not putting an alternative economic management strategy on the table. What would he do differently to, in his own words, prevent himself from chewing the meat down to the bone and sending the country to the IMF if forever he ever had a second opportunity? He has still not been able to answer what he would do differently in that case. And even in current terms, beyond what is currently being managed by the managers of the economy, he has still not been able to explain exactly what he would do differently.
Former President Mahama said the distribution of the ambulances mean little if hospitals which were being constructed during his tenure are not completed. But Kojo Ponkrumah insisted it is a good addition and a necessary boost for health delivery.
Is the former president suggesting that at the time that his party was demanding that the ambulances be distributed now, they had no faint idea of where they would take people to when they are distributed? So it was just a demand that distribute the ambulances now, just an attempt to create some disaffection or embarrassment? Or is it that now these comments are the ones that are just politically thrown out there just to try and cause some disaffection for what government has done? And the Mills Mahama administration at the time announced that they were going to bring in some 600 ambulances. At the time they made that announcement, not all hospital projects across the country had been completed. So in their calculation, when they were bringing in their 600 ambulances, where were the ambulances going to take people? And at the time that they were demanding that the ambulances should be released, where were the ambulances going to take people? I think it's quite clear that this is a good addition to the healthcare infrastructure of our country. And the former president will be better served if he contributes to the new conversation about, for example, how are you going to maintain these ambulances? How are people going to pay for them? How are you going to ensure that prank calls are reduced to a bare minimum?